while I've had this in my toolbox for years, here's why I no longer recommend these pen style brake fluid testers. Now let's get this. My experience started after I flushed the brake fluid from this 2008 Toyota Matrix, which had suffered brake failure from vapor lock. As expected, the flushed brake fluid had more than 4% of water when I used this brake fluid tester. However, when I finished the procedure and decided to test the fresh brake fluid from the leftover in the last bottle, to my surprise, it also had more than 4% of water. Convinced I probably had a bad batch from STP, I went ahead to procure three more brands of .3 brake fluid: Johnson's, Prestone, Honda, and a brand new bottle of STP. I opened all brands, taking care not to contaminate any of the bottles. Yet again, to my horror, all these brake fluids from STP to Johnson to Prestone and finally Honda all had more than 4% of water, meaning that they were not fit to be put in any car, since this much water in the brake system can cause brake failure. At this point, I knew there was a problem with the tester, since it's highly unlikely to have this much water in fresh unopened brake fluid from four different reputable manufacturers. It was at this point that I started to dig a bit further into brake fluid testers and how they work. This kind of brake fluid tester is known as a conductivity tester. Water in any braking system makes the fluid to become conductive, and this tester simply measures the conductivity of brake fluid across these two prongs. It then uses this value to make an estimation of water content. So as you would see here, if I put the two prongs against the metal part of my car key, it lights up with greater than 4%, since this metal is a very good conductor. It turns out that many brake fluid manufacturers actually warn against using conductivity testers for their brake fluid. This is because some brands may use additives in their brake fluid which makes the fluid conductive out of the box. While these pen style testers are not necessarily a bad thing, the challenge is that for them to function across board, they need to be calibrated to each manufacturer's brake fluid formula. My guess is that these pens probably operate on a generic brake fluid formula which doesn't work across all the brake fluid brands. While a multimeter can be used to estimate the water content in the brake system, if a manufacturer uses conductive additives in his brake fluid, that could also throw off the voltage readings of the multimeter. Although there are other ways to test brake fluid, including using copper test strips or boiling point testers, for now I'm going to be sticking to my owner's manual recommendation of changing brake fluid every 3 years. If you're a shop and have clients who don't know when last they changed their brake fluid, you may resort to using a brake fluid boiling point tester. That's the most accurate thing, even though it comes at a cost. Hope this was helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace.